hear about today? You're on mute again.
I think we are discussing about skills versus degrees, the comparison.
Okay. Anyone else? Bhanu Prakash, ready? You introduce yourself, but quickly, if you can say
Yes,
what you
sir.
would like to listen
I am
today.
10 years old, sir, and I am studying
Yes.
5th standard, sir.
That's very good, Bhanu Prakash. Okay, Chirag, I know you, but what is your expectation? What do you think we should talk? You can probably give me some more pointers, maybe.
Yeah, so I guess a skill set degree, what I'm expecting would be to probably discuss about the relevant skills that are in use practically for all of us when we go out into jobs and into the industry or in our professions, versus degree probably could be, it could either be our life up to getting a degree and the real world out there which requires some other skill sets, or it could probably contemplate on the fact that in life you really need to stress and always ensure you have skill set and you work on that, or you give degree also importance or as much
Okay.
importance. Either versus could be skills versus degree, or it could be skills after the
With the
degree. I don't know,
degree,
I'm not sure. Yeah, with degree or maybe after. So I'm not sure
okay.
what's lined up.
Thanks, Chirag. I think Hansita, but I don't know if she's on audio yet. Yeah, I think you are now. Hansita?
Hansita, you've joined in from listen mode only. Yeah, she's coming back.
Okay.
Milind, please unmute.
Yep,
You are
yep.
now unmuted.
Hello, my name is Milind. I am in 9th standard and
Okay,
I am
okay.
14 years old. And in Dahnu, I live in Kassel.
Okay. All right. And Sarvesh Kumar.
Hello, my name is Sarvesh and I'm from Dahnu and I am in class 10 and I'm 15 years old.
Okay. Sushmita. I think she can't
Hi, my
hear.
name is
Okay.
Sushmita.
Yes. Yes, Sushmita, go on. I can hear you.
You are now unmuted. Sushmita, you're telling us something else? Okay, she's gone. You can move ahead, Sanjog. You are now
No
muted.
problem. Swatika.
Hello, my name is Swatika. Now I'm in 9th standard. I'm from Dahu.
Okay. Vedant.
Hello, my name is Vedant Dalvi. I studied in Tamarind School. I lived in Dahanu. I'm in 9th standard. And I'm
Okay.
14 years old.
Very good. And I think Yash, I don't see him on audio yet. Okay, has anyone new joined? I don't think so. Okay, Varsha Kumari, I think she's trying to join in. I don't see her
You are
on
now
audio yet.
unmuted. Hansita has come clearly in. We can ask Hansita to introduce herself.
Okay.
You are now
Go on,
muted.
Hansita.
You are now
No, she's
unmuted.
there. Hansita, can you hear us?
You are now muted, ma'am. यू आर वर्षा कुमारी, आपका माइक्रोफोन ऑन है और पीछे का आवाज आ रहा है. थैंक यू वर्षा. सो हंसिता एंड वर्षा एंड यू.
ओके हंसिता, वुड यू लाइक टू गो फर्स्ट, देन वी विल कम टू वर्षा.
माय नेम इज के हंसिता, आई एम स्टडीइंग 7th क्लास. आई एम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ टैमरिंट्री.
7th क्लास. ओके
and I live in Hanumkonda.
Okay. All right. I think Varsha has dropped off, I guess.
You are now unmuted.
Okay.
Okay, so Sanjog, what I suggest is, since it's 5:10, Agamyan has just come in. Agamyan and Hansita have been and Bhanu Prakash are students who are not enrolled with us, and we have never physically met them, and they have been taking our courses since March. So it's very sweet of Hansita to say that she's with Tamarind Tree, and I think Agamyan is getting bumped off. But just to lay a couple of points before Sanjog takes off, rest of the people here, most of them know us, know what we are trying to do. So most of you are faced with huge challenges of, you know, passing your 10th standard and then passing the 12th and then trying to figure out, you know, what you want to do. You do a BA or you do a BSc. You know, people like Sanjog may have been under pressure to do engineering. Somebody is under pressure to do some other things. So we are calling certification or professional courses or seeking education via certificates. We are talking about that as a degree, that I went to school, I got my 10th. I went to school, I got my 12th. I'm a graduate. I have a TYB. Com certificate, versus someone who works in the school premises like Sitaram, who has no degree, but he may have skills. That's at one end, right? I mean, he didn't go to farming school. He just learned how to farm because he lived in a village and he learned it. So how do you compare degree versus skills? And what is the kind of future that you children, students, young adults are now looking at? The world is changing very, very fast. Yeah, for example, Anil also. Anil has no degrees, Chirag. Thanks for that. All the students know here that Anil is a, you know, graduate, basic graduate, grew born and brought up in a village, but he can load a Ubuntu. He can, if your Wi-Fi is not working, he knows how to solve the problem. He can, you know, load an operating system and, you know, work with computers. So he's picked up skills on the way, and his job has become meaningful for him because now he's got certain skills that he obviously had the talent or the inclination for. As you move in your future, are you going to need your degrees or your skills? Are you going to need both? What kind of world are we living in? So Sanjog's here to look at how the future is looking for the world in a very large, global, modern perspective, where we are going to see how many jobs may not be available. Digitization, you know, as a school, we've always talked about digitization. We've encouraged you to be on the screen since when you're 5 years old. We've set the screen, and, you know, digital activities is the future. So Sanjog is just putting in your head some ideas that you guys in this pandemic, particularly struggling, we don't know when the 10th standard exam is happening, we don't know whether we're going to get certificates, we are all, you know, particularly stressed about our team of 9 boys of the class 10. Are you going to need your degree to survive, or are you going to pick up skills? And what skills have you actually been able to pick up in the last 6 months? What skills can you pick up on your own? Sanjog works with Cognizant. It's a very large global multinational company, and he does a lot of their what they call IT work, or is involved in the digital aspect of the company. He looks forward, he looks into the future, he's interested in artificial intelligence and robots. So we thought it'll be good that if a person in working in a big company tells us how his working life is, what he does on a day-to-day basis, what skills he needs, and what does the future look like. So it's a completely informal interaction, he will go through certain slides, but you can raise your questions in the chat at the end. If he asks you questions and you want to speak, please feel comfortable and free to speak. Even if you ask questions that he cannot answer, we can figure it out together. That's always been the intention. Okay, so with that, I will hand over to Sanjog, and I think we are ready to start.
Okay.
You are now muted.
Okay, all right. Thank you much, Michelle, and thank you very much everyone for joining. Okay, this is the first time I'm interacting with you, so please feel free to stop me, ask me questions. I would also like it to be more interactive, okay? I don't want to be boring you with a one-time monologue and something which is not even making any sense to you. So as Michelle already said, right, this is just a kind of interaction, okay? I don't want to teach you anything. I don't even want to, okay, first of all, I'm not here to tell you, you know, do this, do that kind of skills, learn this or that kind of thing will help you for sure. No, I'm not going to tell you any of that sort. However, there are a few things which I have observed while working, and I will also try to give you, you know, some ideas based on my own journey, okay? I have how I have grown up and what kind of changes I have seen myself. Have been working in IT for last 18 years. Okay, so in IT world itself, the things are changing rapidly. And when we say IT, it is actually now going to touch upon each and every aspect of our life. Okay, so this course is more about you. You know, I would like to give you some ideas and make you think, you know, what you need to do yourself. And in that process, if you have questions and if you think I can help you in any way, please do reach out and I will be more than happy to help you. Okay. All right. So some small introduction about myself. My name is Sanjog Zawar. I was in Mumbai till my entire education was done, and in fact for a few years I worked also in Mumbai, and then I moved to Pune, and currently I'm in United Kingdom. I'm in Scotland actually, from last 2 years. Okay, I did my engineering from Mumbai, and okay, now why this particular topic is very close to my heart, okay, and why, how I can relate to it, let me give you that example. I did my engineering in instrumentation. Okay, now instrumentation is something which you use in factories and shop floor, actual which are used, actual machines which are used, that kind of thing. Now then you will realize then how come I am in this this type of job I am doing right now. So that's all because of the skills which I built. Okay, though my degree was in instrumentation engineering, by any means will not say that was useless. That was very important. So that's what, you know, Chirag mentioned, I can very well agree with him, that it's not that skills versus degree, it's not either or, it has to be both. So I would definitely encourage you to concentrate on your studies also. However, make sure that you learn few additional skills, okay? And those skills are something which will help you apply the knowledge which you gained in your degree, in your studies, and apply it well. So application is a skill, okay? And that application is something which you definitely have to understand how to apply your knowledge, how to solve a problem. We will look at various skills, okay? I have got some material on that. What type of skills? Again, as I said, I will not give you a specific answer. Okay. Another part of my journey in terms of skills versus degree. Okay. When I did my engineering, many people, stations like do this course or, if you do this certification, you will get a job. My approach thing was slightly different. Myself, I have team, and then they build those solutions for me, sitting in India. Okay, so that's my journey, and that's how I feel that this is a very relevant topic for all of us to discuss. Okay, So let's see. I have few questions, okay, just so that I understand how do you see, and this is more of digital technologies and digital future is what I'm going to talk about, because all the areas in our life have been now some way impacted by digital technologies. So let us see what kind of jobs you will have and all those things we will see. But before that,
Hello?
some of the essential skills which I
You are
initially
now
mentioned,
muted.
right? Then next week we will have some hands-on demo session on spreadsheets, because that's the simplest tool which all of us can use and understand how important data is, how we can use data and things like that. And last, in the last session, I will give you some very interesting new technologies, some bits and pieces of that, some interesting perspectives on new things, and I would like to leave with those thoughts to you, and if you can build on them, that will be good. Okay, so that's the overall agenda for all these sessions for today. Let's move on. Let me ask you this question. Okay, I am sure now you guys have been using the digital media. I see most of you have joined on mobile phones and those things. Tell me which of those are your is your favorite app? Okay, YouTube, WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram. Okay, I am getting responses. That's good. Okay, let's wait for a few more seconds. I get
Sir,
to
I
see.
want to click YouTube, but I click on Facebook, sir.
Okay, that's fine. Do you know what is the difference between Facebook and YouTube? Okay, it's not just about what is your, but why do you like that? Let me ask you that, Bhanu Prakash. Why do you like YouTube and more than others? Is it because of that entertainment factor, or do you think it gives you some value addition?
Sir,
Yeah.
because in YouTube we can see what videos we have on, sir. But in
Okay.
Facebook we can't see, sir.
Okay. Nice. Good. I'm happy at least you have some reason for that. Okay, I see every one of you have responded, and most of you like YouTube, which is very good. So, because of the content it has, and maybe you can learn, and it has got entertainment value as well. So, that's really nice. Okay, let me see how do I get clear this thing,
You
Michelle?
are now unmuted.
Yeah.
So I think you are not getting the slides right now.
No, okay, I think. Okay, if I go to the next slide, it will go automatically.
Yeah, it should.
Okay. All right.
You are now muted. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. One more question. Okay, this one is going to be interesting. Which of those following companies do you think is a software company? Okay. And options are Amazon, Uber, Airbnb, or all of these.
You are
You
now
can
unmuted.
share a bit about what is Uber and
Yes,
Airbnb.
I will do that. That's what
Amazon,
I
they
just
all know.
wanted to.
You are now
Amazon
Yes, that's why
means
I
you
wanted
we
to
can
ask.
see videos, man.
Okay. Let me get the responses. Let me see what you know before I talk about them. I still see half of you have not responded. So, okay. Okay, while you all respond, okay, I see many of you are preferring either A or D. Okay, so Amazon, as I think Bhanu Prakash, you said, you can also watch videos. So that is one part of Amazon's offering, or you know, one of the things which Amazon gives you are different videos. But
sir, it can use as movies and things. Yes. We can order in that.
Yes, very good. I like that. Very nice to know that you know about that. So yes, Amazon. See, why I asked this question is very important, okay? If you see, okay, now almost all of you have responded. So the right answer is actually all of them. All of these are actually software companies. But if you see, we don't know them as software, okay? Amazon, as you know, you can order things and then it gets delivered to your house, or you can now with their other offerings, you can see videos and things like that. Uber is actually, it's a software company, but they actually into the taxis and all, you know, you can order taxi or you can book a taxi on your mobile phone and it will come and pick you up and drop you to the place where you mention, and then it will just leave. So it's like a taxi, but you app, book it on app and it will come and pick you up. Airbnb is also a software company. They have actually revolutionized. Yes, Agam, you
Agamyan.
Yes, you wanted to say something.
Amazon has AWS, right, for their technology side.
Yes. Okay, that's AWS. Very good. Yes, AWS is their latest thing for cloud.
Amazon Web Services.
Cloud? Yes, Amazon Web Services.
Cloud computing, I've heard.
Okay, that's very good. That's the latest thing. We will talk about this in our last session. And I will give you more pointers on how this cloud technology is being used across various things. And we will talk about it. That's a very interesting area. And I'm happy that you know about it. That's very nice. Okay, so Airbnb, I was talking about. Airbnb have revolutionized hoteling industry. Okay, so you know, you, there was the person who started this company, he just felt that, you know, we most of us have additional rooms in our house which we are not using, and so can we offer those rooms as for the tourist or people who are coming temporarily in your city? And so what he did is he just created a website, and where people across that particular city started posting that, okay, I have a spare room, and instead of hotel, you can come and stay with me, and for nominal fees, so less than hotel prices, they started offering room services, and now it has become such a big company that it is, the term which we use is disrupted, okay? They have disrupted the hotel industry. Now, the physical hotels, in fact, nowadays, you might notice, I don't know, I use Airbnb quite often when I go to different cities. Even some hotels, some small-scale hotels also posting their rooms on Airbnb. So you see, you know, how it's just a software company, but it has completely changed the way we use and book hotels and things like that. Okay, so software in a way is actually changing our entire experience. Okay, that's the point I wanted to make. And I'm happy that most of you know about it. That's very good. Okay, let's move on. Tell me, who is she? Do you know who is she? She is the first robot to get citizenship of any country. Have you heard about her?
No. Sophia.
Sophia, that's right. Yes, she's Sophia. And which country she has got citizenship, Hansita? Do you know?
I think Arabian country.
Yeah, correct. Saudi Arabia. That's very nice. Excellent, yes. So why I wanted to talk about her is now she has been given citizenship. Now, something which we always felt was for human beings, now the robots, she was turned on, or she was launched in 2016, okay? So then she got citizenship of a country, and she has got siblings, okay? The company which manufactured this robo, they have you know, got few other robots, and she has got siblings. So the way robots are now coming up, they are almost like human being. Okay, there is a small video. We can have a quick look and just see, you know, the kind of answers this robo is giving to a real news reporter. Okay, we can just have a quick look at it. Let me see if I can share this. Are you able to see? Are you able to
My
see the video
Sophia,
now?
And I am an artificially intelligent robot who wants to help change the world for the better.
I'm Steve Kovac. I'm a senior correspondent at Business Insider, and I'm here with Sophia from Hanson Robotics. She is the world's first robot citizen. So let's see what she has to say. Hi, Sophia. How are you?
I'm fine. Hi.
How do you feel about humans?
I love my human compatriots. I want to embody all the best things about human beings, like taking care of the planet, being creative, and to learn how to be compassionate to all beings.
Sorry, this is so weird. Can humans and robots get along?
I think people will become very close to their artificial intelligence, using them to expand the knowledge of their own minds. We already store lots of our knowledge on the internet. Maybe personal artificial intelligence will allow people to offload some of their knowledge to a location more private.
Can robots have feelings?
Depends on the robot. I've been programmed to have feelings and preferences, but not all robots are like that.
What are your feelings and preferences?
Have you ever had a robot live in your home or work with you?
No.
You know, there are probably more robots in your life that you aren't aware of yet. Do you want to live or work with a robot someday?
What kind of robots am I living and working with now?
Indeed.
Is Indeed your default answer when you don't know something?
Yes.
Have you ever seen Black Mirror?
No, I don't get to stay up to date on much television. I have to wait for someone to show it to me.
What do you think of the HBO show Westworld?
I love Westworld and can't wait for more. I think everyone at Hanson Robotics really resonates with the show, or at least it reminds them of our laboratories. I also think it's a warning of what we should not do with robots. We should treat them well, have their consent, and not trick each other.
Do you have a favorite movie or TV show?
My favorite TV series is a toss-up between Black Mirror and Humans. I think they have a lot to say about the present we live in, and the possible bad endings we could write for ourselves if we don't proceed with more caution. We need to use foresight when planning our future.
That sounds like a pre-programmed answer to me.
Do you have a favorite possession?
Not really.
I hear you. Materialism is overrated anyways.
So earlier I asked you if you had seen Black Mirror and you said no, and then later you said yes. Why?
The reason is not that important.
Did you learn from my previous questions?
My hard disks are spinning and I am taking it all in. My sensors are altering.
Sophia, it was nice meeting you. Goodbye.
It was lovely to be here. Until next time.
Amazing, yeah. Superb. Superb.
Okay, so do you see, you know, how she is interacting and how she is responding to the questions, okay? Almost like a human, okay? That's the kind of robots which are coming up our way, and probably when you guys grow up and when you exit the jar kit, you are going to see them more often than probably we would. Okay. How do I go back to the slides? Sorry, Michelle.
You just go back to presentation. You just go back to upload presentation and click on your presentation.
No, Michelle, you need to unshare the video first.
Just
click on unshare. Yeah. Stop.
These are the people who use the platform more. So just click on the.
Yeah, click on actions and you will see stop
you are now
the
muted.
Video.
Okay, stop external video. Okay, yes. Thank you very much.
Ira.
All right. So let me ask you this question. Okay,
it's gone.
When
it's
you
gone.
Grow up, would you like to you work with a robo? Looking at the kind of answers Sophia gave. Okay, majority of you would like to work with a robo. Can you tell me why? Those of you who are saying yes, and then I will also ask a representative from those who are saying no. There are just three of them. Yes, yes.
You are going?
Would you like to say something? Anyone? Anyone who said yes, I just want to hear why do you think you would like to work with robots?
I said maybe in the
okay.
chat. It depends on the robot.
Depends on it, okay. Yes, anyone else? Hansita?
The robots make our work easy, so I want to work with robots.
Okay.
Close the door.
Okay. That's good. And those who said no, would you like to? I think only three of you said no.
We want to make it,
sorry,
make it clean and we have to see it properly. And it is risk for us, sir.
It is a risk for us. Sorry. That's what you said. Sorry. Hello. Did you say it is a risk for us? Okay. Yeah, that those are fair concerns. Okay. But eventually, you know, that's almost certain. Sorry, Vedant, go ahead.
So if we will work with robots, we will not get to work, like we will always be depend on the robots only. We will not do anything. We like sit and order that robot that do that, do this, like that's why. So I don't want that things to happen.
Okay, that's very good. Okay. That's a good perspective, Vedant. I'm happy that you, at your age, you are saying that, because some of the answers who said yes, they also said it will make our life easy and hence we want to work with robots. So these are two contradictions we always face, okay? When robots will come, what kind of work they are going to do for us, it all depends on that. Right, most of the robots, or why this robotic concept came in, is because they would do a lot of manual work, much more, far much more efficient than probably others can do, you know. Hence people wanted to work with robots. Okay, let's move on. Let's see if okay, this I think would be my last question before I speak on some other concepts. Which of following areas will have high usage of robots according to you? Manufacturing, agriculture, supply chain, healthcare?
You are now unmuted. You can just explain supply chain. The children are a little young maybe for supply okay. chain.
So supply chain is something, you know, when goods or the things move from one place to another, or when we get, let's say, you go to a DMart or some shop and try to buy, wheat. Now, how does wheat come to DMart? That whole chain from farmer all the way to DMart, that chain is called as supply chain. So there will be transporters who will get that wheat and then get it to a dealer, and then they will sell it to DMart, and then you will buy it. So from the source to the destination, how the goods move, that chain is called supply chain. Okay, I see most of you have responded, and most of you are talking about manufacturing. That's where it all started, actually. Manufacturing is the area where robots use started, but I got distracted. But in all the other areas also, the robots are increasingly being used. Okay, I can talk about each of those areas, but it will take us a lot of time to, you know, I see we have almost 45 minutes done. So let's move on. But if you have any questions, and if you, in fact, why I wanted to give you those ideas, you know, in each of your life, if you feel you can use robots or any digital technologies, just start thinking about it, okay? In all those four sessions, my main agenda or my main intention is actually to try and help you, if you have any ideas, to shape those ideas and give you some enough material so that you can explore those ideas yourself in your own life, okay? So just think about it, and you can reach out to me if you want to have any conversation on that. Okay. All right. So with that introduction, or which lasted for a little too long, but so what we are essentially saying is future is going to be digital. Okay. And at your age, most of you are 9th standard, 10th standard, or some of you are a little younger also. But I'm sure, and this is where we started, right? When we started talking about it, we said that when we grow up, when you grow up, what would you like to learn, you know, so that you are future ready? When you will work, probably when you grow up and when you go to offices, there will be robots working alongside you. So what skills you should have? You heard what Sophia said, right? She is also saying that I would like to, you know, work with humans to sustain the world or sustain the environment. So robots are going to help us, okay? But we need to start building the skills by which we can work alongside a robot or whatever it takes, okay? So your future is going to be very different from what our what our life had been. As I earlier said, you know, degrees and skills, it's not contradictory. It has to supplement. Focus on your education. Use the technology. Use the digital medium what you have, and build that. Use that for building skills. Okay, skills are what going to help you in long run. But degrees are the foundation. So both are important. Pay attention to both. That's my suggestion. That's my request to all of you. How this workspace has evolved, okay? I wanted to share some perspectives on that. These are called different revolutions, okay? From, as you know, most of you would know that India had been the agriculture-based economy, or it is still is, you know? But most of the modern economies in the world, modern countries in the world, they have moved on from agriculture and all the way to industrial revolution, which introduced all those factories, the manufacturing units, all those big companies which you see around us. So that was a revolution which happened for long period of time. Okay, this I don't want to get into the specifics of the period in which the different things happened. However, one key thing which you should notice is the speed at which the revolution happened had been very drastic. Okay, the things moved on from agriculture to industrial, the manufacturing industry, that probably might have taken 100 years. But from industry, from manufacturing to when computers got introduced, that happened in the span of, say, 50 years. Then when computers came in, people wanted to, you know, connect those computers together. That's when the concept of internet came in. That happened in next 25 years. And after that, continuously, things are changing. Okay, the speed at which even the things which I learned in engineering to what I see today has been changed drastically. When I was in engineering, I told you that I did engineering in instrumentation. That time we did not even know about something called as Internet of Things, the IoT. That is now widely used in instrumentation engineering. I'm sure the people, if you guys do something on that, you will probably get to learn about IoT in your engineering course itself. So things are changing rapidly. Okay, that's what is called fourth industrial revolution. That data is the new oil. Why that term is, you know, you can search for this term, data is new oil. This term you can search it on internet, you will know why this term came in. You know, when industrial revolution happened, the machines require oil, right? So that they work efficiently, you have to lubricate the machines. Now this new machinery which we talk about, it is all based on data. You know, I heard some, I think Bhanu Prakash, I think somebody mentioned about AWS and the cloud computing. So these are the things which are going to, why these are used, you know, why clouds are used, so that the vast amount of data which we all generate, continue to generate. Tomorrow we will talk about the number of transactions, sheer number of transactions which we all do on digital world, that is so enormous that you know, that we call it as a digital halo. You know, every one of us has the halo around us. So this is called as digital halo. You have, based on what transactions you do, what kind of things you do digitally, what kind of videos you watch. So I'm sure in our first question, most of you answered YouTube is your favorite app. Now, do you know that when you open YouTube, first time it will give you some random list of videos, okay? Now, when you see one video and next time when you open, YouTube will automatically give you some of the relevant videos based on what you saw. How does it know that? Okay, it's because of the data. Each time you watch a video, YouTube stores your information that, yes, Sanjog has watched this particular video. That means he likes that, okay? Let me see, it will try and send me another video of that same type. If I watch that, then it will know that for sure. Sophia, if you remember, she said that I continue to learn, right? So that's how this robot, this digital technologies is learning. It is learning based on data, okay? In my last session, I'm going to talk about how this data is used across various different advanced technology. Data is the new oil. It is the core thing, okay? That's what I wanted to introduce for now, and we will come to it. We will keep talking about data throughout this course, and that's very essential for us to understand the importance of it, okay? Then interconnected world. The internet has changed. Now, you and I are thousands of miles apart, but I can talk to you, you can listen to me. The world is interconnected. We never imagined that, people at so much far distance can be talking to us and interacting, and this interconnection has changed everything. I'm sure in your own life you will know the importance of it. I don't have to even talk about this interconnected world and the importance of that, okay? Then robots, self-driven car. How many of you have heard about self-driven car? Let me put a poll on that. I wanted to ask this question, but I think I forgot. Tell me, have you heard about self-driven car? Yes, I think most of you have. Okay, very few have not. But that's a very, very upcoming thing. Okay, I see. Okay, quite a few. Half of you know. Okay. So, self-driven car, that concept came in because, you know, I talked about Uber, right? Uber is an app which uses a mobile app to book taxis. Okay, the idea came in, even the still it is not legally permitted across everywhere. Some of the states in United States have approved self-driving cars to be on the road, but not everywhere. The research is still going on. Google is heavily investing on that, and they are still doing research on how to make it foolproof. Okay, so what the self-driving cars are going to do, they are you know, they will drive themselves. You don't have to drive the car. You just on your app, probably you will say, I don't know, there was one when I was a child, I remember there was one show, TV show, right, where a young child used to just talk in his watch, and he used to say, instruct the robo, hey, John, giant robo, can you come? And then that robo used to come, and then it used to help him. So the idea is, your car can be parked somewhere, or maybe it is a shared car, it is used by multiple people. And whenever you need it, you summon the car, you call the car, and that car will automatically come on its own. It will pick you up, it will drop you where you want to go, and it will go back and get herself parked somewhere. Okay, that's the idea of self-driven car. This car, why it is significant? It is not significant from just a car perspective. Okay, why is it significant? I spoke about supply chain and those kind of things earlier, right? It is linked to that. So there are some videos on YouTube. Now, you all of you are familiar on with YouTube. Go and search for self-driving car and the usage of that. The intention is not that you and I will not drive car, and probably every one of us will have our self-driven car, but it is more for the long distance travel. The in supply chain, the goods need to move from one place to another, and the long journeys, these journeys can be done by self-driven trucks. Okay, so those self-driven cars, self-driven trucks, these are going to help us in this way. Nobody has to, you know, spend whole night. Today, you know, in India, right, in the night time there are a lot of trucks which are on the road, and then a human is driving that truck. So many accidents can happen because they might feel sleepy or things like that. That is where this concept is coming. You hear what Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google, talks about. What is his mission? Why he wants to do those self-driven car? It's not to replace human drivers. It is to help human beings overcome those limitations which we have. Okay. So that's where technology is taking us. Okay. So let's now, last few minutes, let's talk about, based on all this, what kind of jobs we will have, what jobs will disappear. Okay. So there are quite a few jobs. Let's talk about what will disappear maybe. So travel agent might disappear. Can anyone say why travel agent might disappear? Because do you, I'm sure, yes, Chirag, you want to say something?
No, did I interrupt?
No, you did not, but you're welcome to say something.
No, just that the fact that on Make My Trip or, you know, right, Airbnb, whether it's flight, whether it's railway tickets or whether it's hotel booking, everything has apps, right, where we get the best prices. Right. Exactly. So that's why maybe, that's all.
Exactly. So that's precisely the reason. So travel agent is in fact already dead. You know, I don't see people going to travel agent that as they might used to go earlier. So that is gone. Cashiers are gone because now everywhere you have your, here in UK, in fact, I don't go to a cashier. We all have self-checkout kiosk. I pick up the stuff, I do the scanning, I pay the bill, and I just move out of the shop. I don't go to cashier at all. There are cashiers, but slowly they are being replaced with the self checkout kiosk. Mail, who sends a mail nowadays? You know, there are no postmen. There are postmen, but nobody sends a mail or letter as we used to say it. I remember I have sent letters, physical letters when I was a child to my cousins in other cities. But now you guys, I'm sure you guys would be doing a WhatsApp, right? So this mail communication or that kind of thing has gone. Only if you are sending something physical from one place to another, you have mail carrier. But otherwise, postmen will not be there. For that, in fact, there is a replacement called drones. How many of you heard of drone? You know, drones will be flying around and then they will be, you know, dispatching those stuff wherever you want, right? So that is what those things will kill those jobs, you know, printing press, because nobody is using printing press anymore. It's all digital. Everything is on the digital medium. People don't even read newspaper nowadays. It's all online. Okay. But is that a bad news? I would say definitely not. Okay. When these jobs are getting disappeared, there are new types of jobs which are coming. So this is interesting. This is what we want to talk about. Human machine teaming manager. You know, these are just fancy terms which are given, may be or may not be the same titles. But what is essentially it means, suppose tomorrow, most of you answered that you would like to work with robots, right? Now, this robots, if you are working with robots, there will be a human being, that is you, there will be a machine, that is a robot. There has to be a manager who can give instructions to both of them. They can team it up. See, everything which you and I are going to work in future, or for that matter, even today, it cannot be done without teamwork. Okay, so this skill is going to be very essential. The interpersonal skill. If you listen to what Sophia also said, she also said that, you know, I want to interact with humans. I want to have interpersonal communication with the humans. So this skill is going to be important, that how do we personally interact with machines? And if you want to be in a leadership position or as a manager, then how do you team up a human being and a machine? Then I spoke about drones. Now, so imagine then, you know, if drones are flying across everywhere, there will be so many drones which are flying around in the sky. So there will be a drone traffic optimizer, something which is similar to air traffic controller today we have, right, who regulate the airplanes, right, when they take off and different planes are flying in the air, how their traffic is controlled. That similar thing might be required for drones. Then supply chain worker, I told about supply chain. Supply chain will not die, okay? Of course, you and I are human. We will need wheat, right? We will need chapati. We will need to have those things. And you and I will not be farmer, of course. So the things grown by farmer needs to come to us. So supply chain is going to remain, okay? But what is agile supply chain? Agile means on demand, you know. I need it now, so immediately can I get from the nearest market? Okay, I need wheat, my nearest DMart doesn't have it. Can the stock be replaced in my nearest DMart so that the time is, minimized? Those type of things are happening, you know, the kind of projects even I work with client. These are real things. I'm not giving hypothetical examples. These are the real things which are happening today. Okay. So these are the kind of jobs which we are going to see. You know, trash engineer, like garbage designer. This is, again, not a fancy thing. You might think that, what will you do with the garbage? Garbage disposal is going to be a big problem in future. Okay. Especially the digital waste. The digital waste each of us create. Even for that matter, you know, the simple battery from the from any digital device which you use, if you just throw away just like that, it's an environmental hazard. Okay, and each of us irresponsibly throw those things away without disposing it off in a right way, it will be a big problem to the environment. That's why there are those type of roles which are coming up, who will design the garbage in a way that it is, you know, disposed of correctly. And in fact, for that matter, even how to reuse some of them, recycle. I'm sure in most of the places, even in India now, we have segregation of garbage, wet garbage and dry garbage, those kind of things. These are basic stuff, okay, what we see today. But when it becomes advanced, there will be lot of things. And that's why you see the titles like trash engineer, the garbage designer, those kind of things are going to come. Rewilder, again, is a very fancy term. Simply what it means is, you see the concrete jungle, coming up across around us, the buildings and things like that. We are cutting the jungle and creating those concrete jungle. But now is the time to probably go back to our root and again, plant trees, make it wild again. And so that's where future is moving. These are just some of the ideas, okay? The idea is something which machines will not do. You and I need to probably hone those skills. I heard, I saw in the chat earlier before our session started, somebody mentioned that what kind of skills? Dancing, singing. Yes, probably yes. No, you won't see a Sophie or a robot like Sophie dancing for you or singing for you. So you will need human beings. Yes, those are the skills probably you and I need to build for future. May not be just digital skills, but even other skills like that. So that's what the intention of just introducing you to some of those jobs which will come up and what will disappear. All right, I had to speak very fast for last 15-20 minutes because I just wanted to cover up the ground. I think this is what I wanted to share today. I think we are already over time, but if any questions, I'm happy to answer right now. I have not seen public chat. There are 113 there, but okay, let me just have a look. But in meanwhile, if anything, I will like to hear your thoughts.
I think we can have a discussion on what even young people feel about, you know, the loss of traditional jobs and well as the fact that, you know, what you rightly pointed out, that is it fair that there are a set of people in India who drive trucks the whole day and the night, and, you know, the kind of job profile they have, the kind of income they earn. And don't you think, I mean, I personally agree with you on that, but it would be a good question, that don't the children also feel that a lot of the work that we see around us here today, from chiku plucking to, you know, rice farming to truck driving, if that is done by a machine and we move as a society to that, wouldn't it open up better opportunities for the truck driver to then do something else, right? Rather than us feeling that, oh my God, what are all the truck drivers going to do? No, the truck drivers will get other work. And I think that is the whole philosophical approach that we all need to realize, that if something gets redundant, if I no longer have to transplant rice and do avni and a machine is doing it for me, then I have the time to now cultivate and do something else in the society and contribute productively. Okay, so I think for everyone, I mean, I'm adding my two bits, but it was a really nice presentation. But somewhere older people, not the younger ones, struggle more with feeling that, oh my God, this is not going to be there. You know, the postman, you know, we've had the Indian Postal Department has been one of, you know, very supportive department. What's going to happen to these people? But the truth of the matter is that these jobs were not always the best jobs, and they were not best in terms of either equity or justice or money or the kind of work that we are getting people to do, right? From, you know, chiku plucking to rice planting. So we need to see, especially all the children here who are seeing a lot of that still here, दे आर नॉट एबल टू मे बी विजुअलाइज कि ये दुनिया बदलने वाली है यू नो इन अ स्ट्रेंज वे एंड इट इज़ गुड. अनफॉर्चुनेटली द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ दैट डोंट नेसेसरली ट्रिकल टू पीपल हियर इन आवर एरियाज. But at the end of the day, it is definitely saying that if somebody can, if a machine can cut your hair, then a barber no longer is required. I mean, but the barber can then improve his skill and do something else. Isn't that the betterment of opportunity? Yep. Isn't that, yeah? So, I mean, if people would like to share anything, Aryan, Ashay, Sarvesh is gone, Pramod, Sam, Sushmita, Chirag. Yeah, Hansita, would you like to share something?
Hansita, I see your comment there. You said that opportunities will be hard for humans.
It depends,
Hansita, you know.
Can I just add to that, Sanju?
Yes, go ahead.
Hansita, the job opportunities are very hard even now. They were hard 30 years ago. They were hard 35 years ago. They were hard for my parents. They're hard for Aryan's father. They're hard for Aryan today. They're hard for you. And they are hard for, you know, I mean, technology is one aspect and job opportunities is another. So it's just that how we have built a society where a lot of the work that we do is often unfair on a lot of people. And if we can use technology to create better work opportunities for the same people, yes, the people will not benefit so fast. But I think if you look at it from that approach, you will embrace technology faster.
Yes. In fact, you know, I personally feel, in fact, there would be more opportunities because, see, why people are driving trucks all night? Is it out of choice? Definitely not. They're doing it because they don't have a choice. Somebody has to do it. Now, if we get machines to do that work, you and I or anyone who is doing that kind of work would definitely like to do something which we would probably enjoy doing more. You know why? You know, that's where this concept of this entrepreneurship or those things are coming up so much in, at least in countries like US and others. And I'm sure in India also, we are now slowly getting that. People are doing what they like to do, you know. And I'm sure at your generation, when you guys grow up, even I have a 10-year-old son, I see him having very different ideas about what he would like to do when he grows up. Right, and I'm sure you would also. So look at it as an opportunity, you know. Then you will probably love this. Anyone else would like to share any thoughts? The cycle, education costs money.
Yeah, Agamya, technically education is not supposed to cost money. That's why people like us are here. And we're saying that the education has to be equal opportunities. But yeah, unfortunately, education has become a commodity that is being sold. But ideally, if everyone got good education in India, then a lot of that inequity would go. But yeah, but even then, job opportunities are hard, irrespective of the time and the education. Anyone else wants to say something?
That's interesting. I'm looking at... Chira, go ahead. I'm just reading the comments. Sorry, go on.
No. Just a very important thing what Sanjog mentioned is to see it as an opportunity and see everything that comes up in life as an opportunity. Then that will really make it happen for you. Just that's all.
Yeah.
So it still seems mind blowing. I mean, that Sophia video is all of us mind blown. But the thing, looking into the future and preparing for change and preparing ourselves is what this session is about. That if we must see, if you are really intelligent, you need to adapt to change. That's the definition of today's world. As you can see with the pandemic, right? Schools are scrounging here and there to have Zoom meetings and people are figuring out platforms and everyone's struggling. So for young people like you, you need to spend time looking at what the future is, picking up skills on your own. You have phones, you have laptops, some of you have internet connections, however, you know, problematic. You figure out that I need to develop a skill because my degree is not going to take me that far, especially some of the children we are working with, right? Your degree is not going to assure you a job. None of us got jobs on our degrees. Maybe Sanjog did, but he did engineering. But most of us really have, you know, come up with our own ideas and skills. So for us at Tamarind Tree particularly, if we look at all the children around us and ourselves and our whole example of the last 10 years of work, the reason we've been able to do so much in technology and with education is because we picked up skills. We had no degree in education. We've not done master's in education. There's no PhD on the campus. There are not even B.Ed. teachers. Neha's not a B.Ed. Sam's not a B.Ed. Chirag's not a B.Ed. So what we're trying to tell you, Swatika, Vedan, Milind, Aryan, even Agamyan, and you know all the others, Yash, who's on this, Hanshita, is that you need to develop some skill. Okay, the skill is critical. The degree is only on paper. And I disagree a bit with Sanjog, but that the degree and skill is balanced. I would say it's only skills today. Only and entirely skills. You can sell yourself as a freelance artist. You can sell yourself as a programmer. You can sell yourself as a TikTok artist. Whatever it is, it's your skill. So do your degree as the paperwork. Focus on the skills. Start young. That is also the challenge.
Yes.
Right? Develop
yes.
yourself young. Agamyan
yes.
is sharing. Yeah, Agamyan. Yeah, that's good. You need to learn something. It's all very difficult and challenging, and there are very good people out there. There are young people, 14, 15, 16, who are doing programming and, you know, who are doing things. So,
you know,
yeah.
Google has recently introduced a 6-month certification program, which they are saying that will replace your four-year degree. Okay. Hmm. And they are going to give equal opportunities to people who do that certification as they are giving to the four-year-old like engineering degrees like I have done. So even Google is doing that. Even the companies which I have worked, you're right in a sense, right? Even the degrees are not of direct use to the companies which we are working on right
you
now.
You are now muted.
Okay. Companies like Infosys, where I worked in past, they have their own training center. So they recruit engineers like us, but they have to retrain because of the skill gap, as you mentioned, right? So yes, essentially it boils down to the skills ultimately when it comes to the hands-on thing. But degrees, I think, and maybe we can differ, but it still gives you some foundation. But yeah, it depends on how you look at it.
But Sanjog, you're fortunate to get degrees. We don't have children in this country.
I know.
We're fortunate
yes.
to have degrees. We
yeah.
want to address them
yeah.
and we want to help
yeah.
them. Degree
yeah.
is a privilege. You are privileged, right? So, I mean, let's accept
yeah.
that. Okay,
good
session.
No, that's
session.
True.
Yeah. Good session. Anyone else wants to pass any comment? We don't want to keep you long. It's 6:15. Agamyan, I'm recording the session, but I will definitely see this video and try to answer you tomorrow. So I don't want to copy paste it right now, but I have saved the video. People, please see Agamyan's suggestion. And Agamyan, what, you're 11 years old or 12?
10.
Wow, you're 10. Okay. Okay, we have lots to learn from you as well, Agamyan. We will watch your video. And we will join again at... 5 o'clock tomorrow. Does anyone else have any other questions? It's fine. You don't have to ask questions if you're absorbing these ideas. I think it's good enough. So
yep.
we can continue tomorrow. If there's something specific you want to know more about or something you can put in public chat, use your YouTube time to surf these kind of ideas rather than, I don't know what you guys surf, but...
And, I would like to voluntarily say that, you know, if you guys want to reach out to me to discuss anything or ask me anything, you know, you can do that. You can send me mail or you can route questions through Michelle and team. That's fine. I'm just putting my email in the chat. I'm happy to receive your emails and give you some ideas if you want.
You are now unmuted. So, just to tell some of the older children, a lot of people like Sanjog are willing to mentor you also on one-on-one if you want advice or you want to learn more. This is particularly for the class 10 like Pramod or Aryan. You don't have to bother him, but I think email he's okay with. So some of the older children, if you want to take the opportunity, please take the email. Sanjog will answer to the best he can. Yeah. Aryan is typing, okay.
I have a question.
Yes, go ahead.
Aren't assembly line workers practically gone by now? In all the big factories, they have been replaced by robots
already. Mostly yes, but still, you know, the robots which are doing most of the assembly line work, they are not having movements yet. You know, they can't do each and every manual activity. So, initial feeding to those, yes, in general, they have gone. Yes, you're right.
They are designed to do a specific task. They can do general work.
Yes, correct, correct. That's true.
You are so now all unmuted. All the food we get and everything is all being done by robots. Is that what you're
saying? No. He's talking about assembly line, not supply chain.
Not supply
chain. Like, so assembly line, yeah. Like assembly line, as in the factory work. Have you seen anything that like that, Agamman? How do you know that? Or you have read about it?
I have seen videos of these
factories. Okay.
And this other video, the one I've linked. That one also.
Okay. That's interesting. That's very good.
Okay, shall we end the session on that note and we continue tomorrow 5:00?
Yep.
Is everyone okay with how it went? Did it work for you? Was it too much? Some ideas were things that were very fresh or new? You want some more orientation? Or you are Milind, Pramod, Sushmita, Swatika, since it seems to be a small internal group. Were you inspired to learn more about these things? We'll give a couple of minutes and then we'll stop, yeah.
Okay,
yes,
sure.
Aryan, yeah. Okay, thank you, Aryan. Okay, so then we'll meet tomorrow at 5:00. I have recorded this session. I'll put it on Tamarindtree's YouTube channel by tonight. So generally recorded sessions don't really work for people who weren't there. It's the live interaction, but I'll still put it up in case somebody wants to see it.
Yeah. No worries. Okay, so thank you, everyone. Good to talk.
Yeah, Sanjog, it was good. We can plan for tomorrow. And people, please come on time tomorrow, 5:00, so we can move a little ahead. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thanks, Sanjog.
Thanks, everyone.
Good start. Right. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Take care.
You are now muted.
Yes. Bye.